What's the one horror movie that genuinely terrified you while watching it? When I was little, my father would fall asleep on the sofa and leave TNT or AMC on and they would show horror movies. I was maybe 4 or 5 and watched Nightmare on Elm Street. The scene where young Johnny Depp got pulled through a bed gave me nightmares for weeks. This exact situation, but with the original Exorcist and I was a year older. My dad was a heavy sleeper, and I just sat there, completely paralyzed. On the other side of the room, Monsieur Rec is an amazing Spanish found footage zombie movie. It starts slowly with a documentary film crew following a team of firefighters. But once it kicks into high gear, it becomes a relentless, claustrophobic, violent hell ride. I have a friend who is a bit zonked. He told me once when we were talking about movies that he came home from work, watched a TV channel where usually documentaries and such are played. He sat down, made food and started to watch a documentary about a reporter who wanted to show the day in the life of firefighters in Spain. All was good and fine until the one scene with the grandma that started to bite. He was like, "Pum, this could be normal. She is old and confused, maybe she fell, etc." He works as a medic, by the way. Then it all started to escalate and he slowly realized that he was not watching a documentary and was watching the horror movie Rec. He didn't knew that movie, but now he did. The Thing, 82, was a kid when I saw it. Scared the living daylights out of me. Good special effects for its time. Sinister. The soundtrack makes you feel super uneasy. Plus that lawnmower scene was a feeling a horror movie has never done to me before. When I was about 11, I watched The Ring. I couldn't sleep for like 2 weeks. The movie itself was scary, but I had the DVD. And you could watch the tape on its own. That scared the shit out of me. I watched the tape on the DVD to prove to my sisters that it was fake and dumb and I was brave. I was absolutely terrified for a week. Did you die? My friend and I were about the same age when and rented the movie on VHS, lol. We already knew the general premise of the film having heard about it at school. We were about halfway through it when my friend's sister came downstairs. She was about 5 years older and was watching us at the time. She was also kinda bitchy. In the usual way teenagers often are. She decided that she wanted to watch the movie and she didn't want us around to ruin it for her. So she kicked us out of the basement and rewound the movie. Now, we were pretty mad about all this, but my friend had an idea. There was an old trick you could use with landline phones. You could dial your own number then abruptly hang up. This would cause the phone to start ringing. We'd use this trick sometimes to prank call our own houses. So my friend waited at the top of the stairs until his sister got to the part of the movie where they play the cursed video for the first time, called the house, waited for her to pick up, and whispered, 7 days. She literally ran up the stairs screaming and crying. Very hard for us to play dumb given how hard we'd been laughing. We let her believe it for about 20 minutes more before fessing up. We still didn't get to watch the movie, but we got a good story out of it. I was 19 when the others came out and a manager at a tiny old movie theater. We had to build the movies upstairs in the projection booth then watch them to make sure they turned out okay. Imagine being a young female and watching that movie with only one other girl in a really old building. I was terrified when it started brain wrapping right at the jump scare and we had to go stop it and reset. I ended up calling my boyfriend to come down and sit with us. The Strangers. I was very glad I watched it in my one bedroom apartment on the second floor, where there was essentially only one way into my apartment. I could not watch it in my house today, with multiple access points. Because you were home is such a fucked up thing to hear in that movie. Genuinely thought it said, because you're a hoe, when I first watched it. I was in the cinema, so it was definitely loud enough for me to have heard it properly. No idea how I heard it so wrong. Alien. When I first watched it, I had nightmares for weeks. I even had one of those nightmares where you wake up but still dreaming. When that happened to me, I had a xenomorph in my fucking face with both mouths open, stripping saliva all over me. I woke up to my dad shaking me awake covered in sweat, genuinely thinking it really happened. Nowadays I think back while watching the alien films and laugh about it, but that film messed with me. Edit. Just one word, and holy shit, this blew up. You know, one of my top comment is about me watching a horror film and having a nightmare. It didn't really terrify me, but the movie Room 1408 did make me super uncomfortable, and it was great. Like, it's not the best movie ever, but watching the main character slowly go insane was awesome. Really great movie. Removed. Fun fact, Wreck was the original version of Quarantine. The original and better version. Event Horizon 1997. Now it's just funny. I just love how after watching the old cruise log, the guy goes, "We're leaving. Fuck this ship." It makes it terrifying because that's exactly what an average person would say in real life. Kind of relevant. In the video game Outlast, during the beginning there's a Spec Ops guy impaled on a pole. With his last breath he says, "You gotta get the fuck out of this terrible place." The no bullshit simple expression from a guy trained for that stuff makes it so terrifying. Fire in the Sky, The Fourth Kind, was just a kid and had no idea whether it was real or not because of all the documentary footage. Honestly, the only one that had me genuinely scared ever. The Shining has a special disturbing element to it that has never fully let me go. Even though I've probably watched it upwards of 30 times, it still makes me feel just as on edge as the first time I watched it. Edit. A.E. my first silver. Thanks, bro. When I was in my early teens, my mom and sisters worked at a convenience store and would bring home convenience store food and rental movies pretty regularly. One time my sister was supposed to throw out a whole bunch of chopped chicken that was past the expiration date, but instead she brought it home, thinking she could make it into something instead of wasting it. She also brought home The Shining. So that day, a few hours after eating a meal prepared with expired chicken, I watched The Shining for the first time. And as the movie progressed, I felt this overwhelming feeling of unease creeping over me that I attributed to the movie. It wasn't until a few hours later that I realized I was sick from eating expired chicken. But man, you haven't seen The Shining until you've seen it with a developing case of food poisoning. This seems like the twisted, fucked up version of dropping acid for a festival, LMAO. I think Hereditary already deserves a spot on one of the scariest movies. Everything following that scene is an excruciating descent into unbreakable grief that you know will destroy you. It's also a great film because of all the foreshadowing that it has. Orwell, the little clues that tells about the whole picture. Like the daughter saying that the grandma wanted her to be a boy. Or the people in the funeral that nobody knows. The descent. I just want to say, I'm very claustrophobic and I watched this in the middle of the night. Fuck that movie so much. Signs. It's not even objectively that scary. But fucking hell did it scare the shit out of me. I still can't bring myself to watch it or I'll be paranoid going around every corner of the apartment when it's dark. That birthday party scene, though. Edit. Thanks for my first silver ever, my fragapanophobic fellow. Does arachnophobia count? Saw it in theaters when I was young. Good lord, that movie is terrifying. After I watched this movie as a kid, I legit would obsessively check the toilet seat and shower to make sure there were no spiders. We lived in a house at the time that had a crap ton of spiders. So that also didn't help. I couldn't eat popcorn for a while after seeing that. Edit. Spelled there wrong like a derp. Martyrs, that is the only horror movie that's managed to genuinely scar me. Hear me out on this one. Jeepers Creepers. The first one, of course. The first 45 minutes of that film were incredible and downright terrifying anxiety. Unfortunately, it turned into a B movie at the end, but I'll never forget watching it at the cinema. I was gripped. a bit dated now, but at the time, 1 hour photo, it just seemed way too plausible. Truly one of the best dramatic roles Robin Williams took on. I also love Insomnia, also with Robin, Al Pacino, and Hilary Swank. I don't know if it was really scary, but outstanding performances by all three of these legendary actors. The Blair Witch Project. A. It looks like it was filmed where I live. B. I live in the woods in the middle of nowhere, so I hear a lot of weird stuff at night. C. There were some abandoned houses in the woods around me that looked exactly like the house they find in the movie. The best thing about it is, after all, you have no idea what the fuck actually happened. I've gotten into so many arguments with so many people about what they think happened. I've noticed that the real divide seems to be fans who think there's something supernatural going on versus fans who think the Mike and Josh lured Heather into the woods. Personally, I think the witch is a red herring, and the real force of evil are the woods themselves. The real evil is the friends we made along the way. It's not even that scary. The Exorcism of Emily Rose. It may have been the based on true story part that did me. After a month of watching that movie, I started to wake up around 3 a.m. Actually, pretty precisely at 3 a.m. And that was nerve-wracking on top of my continuous nightmares. Those weren't because of the movie, I've always had them. And again, not so scary, but the Bloody Mary episode of Supernatural, which I think is one of genuinely scary episodes they have done. I watched it around 11 p.m. and when that girl said, "Blood Mary," a door in my house closed with a bang. I was alone. It was most likely the wind, but still. Yup, did not sleep that night, and did not look at the mirror for a while after that. Silence of the Lambs. I saw the cinema during its original release in 1991. Scared me plenty good. The first Poltergeist film as well when I saw the cinema in 1982. My father actually ran out of the theater into the lobby for a while during it. The Ring. I saw on its initial DVD release in 2002 and it scared the bejesus out of me. Pulp Fiction, though not a horror film, I saw in the cinema in 1994 and the Zed parts really disturbed me. Zed's Dead, Baby. Not a movie but rather a scene, large march from Pee-wee's Big Adventure. I think I actually shit my pants. The Poltergeist movies of the 80s. Love that chair stacking scene in the first one. It's so damn effective. The Conjuring. That fucking scene where the girl slowly looks up and sees the demon on top of the wardrobe is possibly the scariest thing I've ever seen in a film. I swear to God, as an adult man, I'd shit my pants if I were alone in my house and heard that double clapping sound. Meme review. The scariest moment for me was when Lorraine fell down the basement and saw a pair of floating legs. And the creature floating stopped and approached her quickly. Never before has any movie caused me to push myself backwards in real life. I remember watching 13 Ghosts at about 10 and it scared the shit out me. I rewatched it a few years ago though and it was not as scary as I remember. I saw Annihilation in the theater alone and that movie really freaked me out for some reason. The Bear was bad, but the showdown at the end was the worst for me. That movie really got under my skin. Fuck the Bear. Oh my god, the voice still haunts me. Yeah, one of the Paranormal Activities kept me up once for a few hours one night a few days after watching it. Can't remember which one, but the bit where the bed sheet blows up while somebody is laying in it. Edit. Also, whichever one it is when all the kitchen cupboards open at once. The scene where the woman gets out of the bed and just stands there, staring at her husband sound asleep in the bed just creeps me out. And when she get dragged out of bed, Jesus. I was laughing at first when it grabbed her foot, but when it dragged her down the hall, god damn. Also when she goes downstairs and is just screaming, and the footprints, and the door moving. That whole movie freaked me out and is one of the few movies to actually scare me. The original made-for-TV IT. The scene with the blood coming out of the picture and Pennywise standing in the field scared me so much. I don't think I watched the whole thing at the time because that spider is so bad even 10-year-old me would have laughed. Basically, if you were a kid in the 90s, Pennywise fucked you up. I still get freaked out seeing pictures of his face, and certain scenes are scarred into my memory. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.